I don't know the young comedians community in a way. I know a lot of them because I see them and like them. But when we were starting out, being a stand-up comedian was an odd and unique thing to do. Nowadays, it's not. Nowadays, it's gone corporate. Jewish mothers want their sons to be comedians instead of doctors. When you were dating a girl in my day and you were a comedian, the mother would say, "Are you nuts? He's a comedian. What's that?" Now it is, it's gone overboard for the world. People know now that you can get rich being a comedian if you get a television series and go on the air. The other difference was that when we were doing stand-up comedy, we loved being on television for whatever reason that you were on TV, you know, it would help you. But the form itself was what matters. You love the live performing in front of an audience. Nowadays, people just, the comedians who are working out, they look for their 7 minutes that will impress a network executive to get them a show. We didn't even think of getting shows. Everyone has their bad, horrible experience. And if you're a comedian, there's nothing as bad as being on stage and something not working, because it's not a Broadway play. The audience is saying, it's not the set that we don't like, it's not the music, you. We don't like you. And you have to stand there and work out your material and make sure that they feel they've gotten something for their money. Canadians are funny because I'm asked that a lot, because I, you know, my show that I did in Canada had Marty Short, John Kenny. They'd never been on television before, and they were amazingly brilliant instantly. But the answer to the Canadian, why so many comedians? I think it's because you're sort of an outsider looking in at a window of a culture. And that's a very good place to be as a comedian. And then, or not just a stand-up comedian, just in the comedy world. Then when you get on the inside, then you get a taste of the inside. So that outside-inside thing, I think, is an advantage for someone. And you don't get it if you just grew up in the States. Canada is a different country. The culture is different.
I had the nagging thing of wanting to try comedy. And so I did try stand-up.
Oh, you did.
When before, I got done with
before
college.
The Groundlings.
Before the Groundlings, kind of in conjunction. Mm-hmm. And
do you remember anything that you did? Anything?
Yeah, I had...
Try it on me.
Opening line. Hi, I'm Will Ferrell, and a lot of people don't know this, but I was the original vocalist for the theme to Star Trek. And if you'll indulge me, I'd love to sing it for you. Yay, okay. And then that would usually get applause, and then I'd say, the reason why I can sing that way is because I have no testicles.
That's funnier than anything I ever did to start. That is so great. I didn't know, though, Steve, that you had done stand-up comedy before you started writing.
Yes, I did. I was doing stand-up comedy from age, as soon as I got out of high school.
Oh,
you
were?
18 on, yeah. I worked at the at Knott's Berry Farm at the Birdcage Theater, and I did a comedy magic act. Then I took that and expanded on it and went down to the clubs that you could appear at in Orange County with my banjo and some jokes and the comedy act, and it developed into this interview.
What a sad end.
Yes.